ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंशर्षभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान गण प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम स्टो मे द ऑल माइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बिस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी वेल्थ हेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद अ परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड योर एंटायर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड योर फ्रेंड्स टू। लेट अस बिगिन भगवद्गीता वर्स नंबर 16 ऑफ फिफ्थ चैप्टर। श्री भगवान उवाच ज्ञानेन तु तदज्ञानं तेषां नाशितम् आत्मनः तेषां आदित्यवज्ञानं प्रकाशयति तत्परम्। द वर्ल्ड हैज सीन सो मेनी साधुस ऋषिस ज्ञानीस एंड सो मेनी अवतार पुरुषास टू, स्टिल द वर्ल्ड इज कंटिन्यूइंग विद अज्ञान। भगवान कृष्णा से मनुष्याणां सहस्रेषु कश्चित् यतति सिद्धये यततामपि सिद्धानां कश्चिन्मां वेति तत्वतः। इन द सेवंथ चैप्टर इट कम्स एज अ थर्ड वर्ड्स। ही सेज वन अमंग द थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल अ पर्सन हू मेक्स टू रियलाइज मी ही बिकम्स द सीकर। सो वन अमंग द थाउजेंड्स ऑफ सीकर्स गेट्स a kind of proper guru shastra to proceed with, and among that kind of sadhakas, one among the thousands of people gets to know, he realizes the real reality about me has his own real reality. It means the nature of the world is to continue with ajnana. And one among the thousands of people are enlightened prarabdhavashat with the good fortune. Now we are studying Bhagavad Gita. We are definitely fortunate people. So one person had come after one of my classes. In that class, I had taught. So throughout the life, we deal with so many incidents, so many accidents, so many people. Every day, can you imagine that how many people you interact with? How many objects that you take and you touch and you interact with? Physically, how many objects we carry with us? Including the cloth and body, we have been interacting with lots of objects, with lots of people in every day's life. You think about throughout the life how many people, how many incidents, how many accidents, how many success, how many failures, how many moments that which were very happy, and how many moments we felt ourselves lonely. These all these incidents, all these events, all these things, generally, final understanding, according to Shastra, we dealt with all the shadows. You may be shocked when you hear this. Because Shastra says, that's what the truth, my dear, you have to accept it. That person who came after the class said, Swamiji, exactly this is true. I said, how, sir? He said, I lived with my wife for 35 years, Swamiji. We had lots of success, incidents, as you told me. So many experiences. We had children. We interacted a lot in everyday's life. She passed away 2 years before. Now she is no more. Every day when I get up from my bed, I feel as though she is bringing my bed coffee. When I open my eyes, I see her absence. My mind is not ready to accept. And my mind is fighting with me. What went wrong? Where she has gone? Is she there or not? My mind is, you know, it's struggling to find the reality to go with practical life. I'm not the person, Swamiji, who thinks, yes, it's gone. Gone means gone. She won't come back. I always think when I met her, everything, it seems to be like a dream. It's a huge dream. Nothing is there with me. Even my children, they got married and they were with their families. Now, I am the one who is with me. I don't know this body when it is going to go. You were right. This body is also a shadow. Finally, I felt myself, I am dealing with the shadows. Then I said, no, you came only few classes of mine. You have to continue from the beginning. You have to begin the Shastra with a proper method. You keep attending the classes. And also you can attend the courses and all. The Shastra will give a complete knowledge. Don't conclude. When Shastra says everything is a shadow, the same Shastra will also say that everything is nothing but Brahman. But here in these words, it talks about Ajnana. When you interact with the world with Ajnana means, what? Ajnana means ignorance. Ignorance of what? Ignorance of the self. No other ignorance, like if you don't know how to drive, how to swim, how to cook, doesn't matter. You can be loaded with lots of ignorance of the worldly object. There won't be any problem. If you are ignorant to your own self, that becomes the problem. The self-ignorance is the center point where the locus of error, all the mistakes, all the dealing, it is converted into a mistake. When you are not clear about yourself, you are not aware about yourself, you are dealing with the people like a blind person. You introduce yourself the data which are provided by your parents, society. Now you give life to this shadow. Shadow means you construct the bridge which is false one. When you are aware about yourself, then you know how to deal with the other object and beings. Then every moment, every action which comes from you, it will be meaningful to you and others even. First, you have to accept, yes, I am loaded with ignorance, that self-ignorance. We need not to find when it was loaded, when the connection with ignorance had happened. Vedanta never worries about it. It says, you need to have a transformation. You need to have a proper information about you, that which helps you to transform yourself from incomplete to complete one. From inadequate to adequate one. When you realize as the adequate personality, your every action, every word becomes adequate attitude. I mean, every word you make, there won't be longing for adequation. You will get Purnatvam. That Purnatvam is known as Brahmajnanam. That's what Krishna is bringing nicely at the same time carefully. Yesham ajnanam atmanah jnanena nashitam, whose ignorance is slayed by the knowledge of atma. It's not an easy thing. You are a special person. When you realize about you properly, you become a special person in this creation. Because you can withdraw from the creation. How beautifully Shastra brings to a conclusion. A creation is in you. When you realize yourself properly, you need not to work with moon, you need not to work with sun, you need not to work with any other force which creates the world. Just you have to realize about yourself. What is the big deal in it? It's not a big deal. It's a challenging job. Why? Because throughout the world is working with ignorance. Once you started thinking, realizing it, you can be a special person. That special person is known as a jnani, one who is practicing jnana yoga. That special person who becomes a center of the creation, who can withdraw himself from the creation, who becomes the author of creation, who is also aware about his swarupa, he can identify himself with Ishvara. So whose ajnana is being slayed? The jnana is lightening from inside. It's not coming from anywhere else. Because our self is a self-effulgent self. Because of our ignorance, it was not aware, it was not recognized by us. So when ajnana is slayed, jnana comes and enlightens like a sun comes every day morning, enlightening the world. After that, you will be darkless person. You will be called jnani, atma jnani. That's what the person is known as, Prakashavan. This is known as a self-realization. After the self-realization, what will happen? The next verse describes it.
Tadbuddhayastadatmanah tannishthastatparayanah gacchantyapunaravrittim jnananiddhutakalmashah.
This person becomes tadbuddhayaha. Those all people whose knowledge is being taken place, ajnana is being slayed, they are called tadbuddhayaha. Tadbuddhaya means Brahma buddhayaha. After realization, they don't think I'm a jiva, limited persons. They will be endowed with the buddhi which enlightens the Atma. Now they have Brahma Buddhi. Before the knowledge, they had Anatma Buddhi. They were thinking, I am the body, mind and sense complex. So my parents, they are. I am their son. I have the son. I am the father to my son. I am the husband to my wife. I am the brother to my brother. I am friend to my friend. I am the senior to my junior. I am the junior to my senior. Anatma buddhi, the buddhi which was accompanying with body, mind and sense complex. Okay. That is what anatma buddhi, abrahma buddhi. Now their buddhi is endowed with the enlightenment of the self. Now the buddhi is working properly, the buddhi which helps or in which the proper identification has taken place. Now if you ask those people, who are you? They will say that I am nothing but Brahman, aham brahmasmi. Not with garva, not with ghamand, not with ego. In polite way say that, so aham brahmasmi. Aham Brahmasmi is the Mahavakya from the Upanishad. I am that Ishvara. I identify myself with my real nature. That real nature is nothing but the nature of the Ishvara. Okay? That is known as Tadbuddhayaha, Tadatmanaha, Tadatmanaha. Then they think that that self is Atma. So all the self is Atma. All the self means what? Not only the self which is experienced in my body, in all the Sharira, whatever the selves are experienced, they are none other than one self, that one self which experienced as the I, Tadatmanaha, Tanyathaha. Their mind is not attracted by the shadows because worldly object has got the limitations. Their mind crosses all the limitations. Tat parayanaha means, so those people, they have no targets because they are achievers. So ayanam means marga. Tat parayanaha means, so those people, just they are endowed with the goal itself, no longing at all. Ramasya ayanam, Ramayanam. Ayanam means marga. The marga which takes to Rama is known as Ramayanam. But here, their lifestyle is marga darshak. It's an example for others to reach Brahman. Tatparayanaha. Those people, after death, while living itself, they live like a Jivan Muktaha, free from all the bondage. They are liberated consciousness, liberated soul. They, after the death, they just become one with the reality, Brahman reality. They actually gacchanti punaravrittim. Because of the knowledge, they are purified people. They don't come back into the womb, embryo. It means they won't be born again because they closed their account with the Srishti. Okay, but Shastra says if they want to be born again, they can make themselves into a new birth. That is known as a Parecha Prarabdham. But here Gita, Bhagavan Krishna doesn't say it. The Vichara Sagara talks about it. A Brahmajnani can get the rebirth if he wishes, that also with selflessness, not with selfishness. Because no Ajnana, so no Ajnana means he won't get birth again, but if he wishes, he can be born as Avatara. So it seems to be, it's too much, but Shastra says that's what the truth is. This is how every, you know, even Shuka Maharishi, he had the birth. So Gita, Krishna had the birth, Rama had the birth by using Swamayaya Sambhavami. You become author to the creation. How big science we have, every one of us should realize. This science exists only in the Bharat Sanatana Dharma. The next words, Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavihastini Shuni Chaiva Shwapake Cha Pandita Samadarshanaha. How will they interact with the Ajnanis? How will they interact with the world? These are all normal questions, you know, how Jnani. Usually when we have the breakfast, everybody will be looking at us, you know, how they eat. We eat in normal way. Means, we eat in normal way means Jnanis. We eat normally. You have to be confident enough. Once you realize the Bhagavad Gita, you yourself should think that the person who is said in the Gita, it's me. Okay? Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavihastini. He is having the equal-mindedness, the Samatvam. He could see everything is nothing but the consciousness. He won't find the difference. Though there are difference between human beings, animals, and between dead materials and animals, So for him, everything is nothing but consciousness. He won't find the difference, but there are difference with outer appearance. He the jnani who could see the difference through physical eyes, but in buddhi he won't see the difference. Because his buddhi is occupied with brahma jnanam, therefore he will see all among all the difference only non-different brahman. That is what known as samadarshinaha. So equal-mindedness among what? Among this learned brahmana, so who is very scholared and cultured and matured brahmana, and gavi and with chandala brahmana, he will be having equal mindedness with all of them. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavi hastine shuni chaiva swapake cha. Swapake means a person, one who eats dog, having less quality life. He won't find, the physical eyes may find the difference between these two people, brahmana and the swapaka, swapaki, one who eats the dog. We used to say chandala. He won't see the different. The buddhi will see only brahman, because buddhi does the matter. And he won't find the gavi hastini shuni. Gavi means horse, hasti means elephant, and shuni means dog. Doesn't matter animals or human beings or other beings, for him everything what is seen is nothing but Brahman alone. That's what samadarshana is. The inner core of the jnani is connected with Brahman. For him everything is nothing but Brahman. What is the benefit he gets out of having this darshan? Darshan means perception. Said in the next words, ihai vatairjita sargaha yesham samye sthitam manah nirdosham hi samam brahma tasmad brahmani te sthithaha. He won't get, or he won't affected by this darshan, the samadarshan. How can we have equal darshana towards the brahmana who is very cultured, matured, towards a person who eats dogs and living a wrong life? If by having this darshana, he may get affected by papas, isn't it? Then this word says no. While living itself, he has come out of the srishti. The world cannot affect him. Sargaha means all the things which is caused by the srishti. He won't be affected by any doshas or object. In fact, all the dosha vastu, all the defected vastu object, when he looks at them, they are purified. When he touches them, it is purified. He becomes a golden person. By touching everything, he can convert gold. I gave as an example. So when he looks at the things, so all of those things are purified. Nirdosham, because Brahman is nirdoshaha, defectedless. It cannot be affected by any bad deeds or evil deeds. Tasmat brahmani te sthitaha. So everything exists in the Brahman. Brahman cannot be affected by any doshas. And the Brahmajnani's nature, again on time, described by Lord Krishna. Let us read it. Na prakharushyet priyam prapya, no dvijet prapya cha priyam, sthira buddhira sammoodaha, brahmavid brahmani sthitaha. Now jnani has a challenge to deal with his own prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma means the karma which has started giving the fruits. So in between he got knowledge. Now what will happen with his physical system, that we will see in the next session tomorrow, in the next episode. Harihi Om.
ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांतिः हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम।